Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another episode of Imperial Diecast, and today I want to show you the most beautiful ambulance that was ever made, the 1959 Cadillac Miller Meteor. Before we take a look at it, let's talk a little bit about the box. This was part of a subscription-based collectible series back in 2017 that was focused on ambulances and made by the company Atlas in 1/43 scale, and these models used to come with a small booklet, which is usually not sold alongside this model anymore. And I have already reviewed another ambulance from this same series on my channel, a Volvo 264 from the mid-70s, which you will find linked to at the end of this video. So as we take a closer look at the box, you can see that we have different sketches of ambulances here. And then over here, we actually have a series of black and white pictures that show various ambulances from the 40s, over the 50s, and into the 60s. So you can see these pictures look pretty good. And then over here at the side, it just says ambulance collection, and down here, we simply have some warning information. Scale 1/43. So now let's unbox this. And the only downside of this ambulance series is that while the cars come with a base, they don't have a plexiglass cover, which is unusual for 1/43. Instead, you get this blister wrap kind of thing, and so if you want to display this car without wanting it to catch dust, you either need to have a display cabinet or buy a separate 1/43 acrylic case for it. Now let me get this out so we can have a better look.
Mr. Sandman, bring me a dream. Make him the cutest that I've ever seen. Give him two lips like roses and clover. Then tell him that his lonesome nights are over. Sandman, I'm so alone. Don't have nobody to call my own. Please turn on your magic beam. Mr. Sandman, bring me a
So here she is, the absolutely beautiful 59 Cadillac Miller Meteor. I bought this in late 2021 from an eBay seller for 13 euros. I've seen it retail for as low as 10, but these days it usually retails for 15 euros, 20, sometimes 30, but even at that price, it is a great alternative to the resin Cadillac ambulances offered by Neo, because they're like $100 per model. And if you look at the differences to the Neo version, it's really hard to tell. I mean, for one thing, the Atlas version is lacking the printed Red Cross decal on the side window that then sort of continues on like a frosted striping across the rear quarter window. But apart from that, and the better looking headlights, there's really nothing I can immediately tell is different. But the price and availability are the real issues of the Neo. So that's why I love this Atlas casting as a readily available, amazing-looking and affordable alternative, and it's actually the most amazing-looking 1/43 scale car in my collection, and I still have a ton of 1/43s to show you, but this time I couldn't save the best for the last.
This ambulance is built on the Cadillac commercial chassis, which was a framework that Cadillac delivered to coach builders who would then either build an ambulance or a hearse around it, and in some cases, estate wagons like the Broadmoor. And the commercial chassis also served as the design basis for Ecto-1 from Ghostbusters. So this involvement of coach builders is also why this particular ambulance is named Miller Meteor. Another famous ambulance would be the Miller Meteor Criterion from the 1970s, which I hope Atlas will also make one day, in the same price range, because Jesus, man, the resin model prices are crazy. Now, the reason Cadillac ambulances are a thing of the past is because in the late 1970s, federal regulations required the chassis to be based on a truck or a van instead of a car. So the design requirements for ambulance bodies moved from an estate wagon type of body to a box-shaped one, which is the sort of ambulances you see in the US today. The new law did not affect the construction of funeral vehicles, though, so the Cadillac commercial chassis continued to be used for them. Which is also why you will find a lot more Cadillac hearses than you will find Cadillac ambulances. So taking a look at the front of the Cadillac Miller Meteor, you can see that Atlas did a fairly reasonable job in replicating the front of this legendary Cadillac from 1959. Perhaps the only downside of this model is that the headlights have pegs in them. And this is literally the only downside of the model. I mean, it's also the only way you can tell this is, at the end of the day, not a high-end model, because from pretty much every other angle, the model is so well made that it looks like an expensive 143 casting. Of course, some people will say that since this is a car from the 1950s, those circular black pegs look like the places where the bulbs would be, so it wouldn't look too off. And I guess they're kind of right, but when you consider the fact that in 1/24 scale, a white box made a Cadillac Eldorado, which I have also reviewed in the past, and the headlights there looked a lot better than here, then you can begin to tell the difference. Underneath the headlights, we have two fog lamps on either edge of the vehicle, so there's actually 8 lights in total. And in between, we have a black grille, which is separated by a chrome slat. And it says Miller Meteor on the yellow license plate. As we move further up, you can see that we have the Cadillac symbol printed on the center. And the hood continues on to the front windshield with these two silver lines on either side and then another sort of ridge in the middle, which is also pretty cool. Atlas also paid really good attention to recreating the windshield wipers made out of chrome and then also this grille here in front of it. And then as we move on further up, you can also see that we have 4 lights and the siren is in the middle. And then further back, we have another light. This, however, is not a separate plastic piece. It is just a chrome bulb that is painted in red shiny paint. And here we are at the side of the 1959 Cadillac Miller Meteor, and this is arguably the best angle on this entire vehicle because it just looks so magnificent. Like, you can't even tell that this is an ambulance, it just looks like a work of art. Now, I'm not sure if this chrome rocker panel is accurate because I have not seen it on the real Miller Meteor ambulance, just like I'm also curious about the Superior branding on top of it. Because Superior was a rival coach builder, just like S&S. So I'm not sure why their name is here on the Miller Meteor. As we take a closer look at the wheels, you can see that the tires have the white walls, and the rims look reasonably detailed, but they are lacking Cadillac logos in the center. However, if we move a little further away from the wheel, you can see that we have a Cadillac logo right here. And we also have this silver trim line that runs along the side. And if we move further up, you can see that this car has the chrome mirrors on both sides, and it also comes with a little antenna. Now, as we move on to the back of the car, let's first take a look at these absolutely legendary tail fins that the 59 Cadillac is famous for. And you can see that we have these chrome tail cones, and at the end of them we have the rear tail lights, which are actually separate plastic pieces instead of being the same metal as the rest of the car body, like on my 1/24 scale white box Cadillac Eldorado. And then further up, we have the rear lights of the ambulance. So here we are at the back of the 1959 Cadillac Miller Meteor, and you can see that we have the exact same yellow license plate. followed by a huge door at the back that would open and give access to the interior of the ambulance. And then we have the four taillights, as I mentioned earlier, and below them we have a reflector housing that is shaped like a jet exhaust. This whole rear end of the car reminds me of the tail assembly area of a jet aircraft. Now let's take a look at the interior of the 1959 Cadillac Miller Meteor. And you can see that despite this being a 1/43 scale car, the interior is actually very nicely detailed. We get a full gurney here, a stretcher, with like chrome handles. And then we also have a seat here for the accompanying doctor. And you can see the door handles over there. And over here we even get like an entire medicine cabinet or chest with like multiple drawers, which is kind of hard to see, but it's there. And then over here we have like another seat. So that is really cool. And then down here we have like a texture, kind of like a drainage, I think, which is also pretty nice. So yeah, these are all the amenities of a late 50s ambulance. And then over here at the passenger side, you get like a little bit of a radio for the dashboard. You can see like some silver buttons there. And you can see the instrument panel right there, but it doesn't have any gauges. A little bump for the speedometer, I think. The seat is done pretty well. And the texture is also done pretty well on the seat. You can see it's dual color, which is really nice. And of course, there's a separator right here between the driver and passenger and the rear area of the ambulance. And now if we move on to check out the driver's side, you can see that we have the steering wheel over here. And that's about it in terms of detail. Again, a good look at the various window cranks and door handles right there. And here is another look at this side of the rear cabin. So I'm very impressed with the level of detail, to say the least. I mean, it's like a really nicely designed interior. Definitely worth the money. So yeah, amazing stuff. And now let's check out the bottom of the car. And you can see it says Cadillac Miller Meteor 1/43 made in China. The entire exhaust system is painted in silver. And then over here it says Editions Atlas Collections. So yeah, that's a fair bit of detail for a 1/43 scale model. Alright guys, thanks again for checking out this review of the 1/43 scale 1959 Cadillac Miller Meteor Ambulance. If you're interested in more ambulances, make sure to check out my review of the Volvo 264. Or perhaps if you're interested in emergency vehicles, you might as well check out the review of my FDNY Seagrave Marauder fire engine. Take care, have a wonderful day. This is Imperial Diecast, signing out.